sorry, ribosomes we are discussing. In that 70S ribosome, I told you 70S ribosome. This 70S ribosome is also called prokaryotic ribosome, where it is present in prokaryotes only. Prokaryotes only means in bacteria it is present, but some eukaryotic organisms also have ribosomes, but not in endoplasmic reticulum. Normally, where ribosomes are majorly present on endoplasmic reticulum, ribosomes are present in eukaryotes. But in prokaryotes, there is no endoplasmic reticulum. Why? Prokaryotes are non-membrane bound organelles. There is no membrane bound structures in prokaryotes. As there is no membrane bound structures in prokaryotes, there is no ribosomes are present on ER or endoplasmic reticulum. Simply ribosomes are present in cytoplasm itself. In that cytoplasm, this 70S ribosome is present. In eukaryotes also 70S ribosome is there, but where it is present means inside the chloroplast or mitochondria. As we discussed in previous classes, there is presence of that one. Okay, this 70S ribosome is made up of two subunits. One is a larger subunit, which is made up of a 50S subunit, and a small subunit, which is made up of 30S subunit. Okay, see the structure of ribosome. If you see that ribosome, ribosomes are made up of two subunits. Like this, we can write a simple diagram, a block diagram of ribosome. Ribosome is made up of two subunits. A small subunit, which is 30S subunit, a larger subunit, which is 50S. 30S smaller, 50S larger. Both is called as 70S ribosome. How, sir? Here, 30S plus 50S means 80S, na, sir? How 70S is coming, sir? Like that, you may ask doubt.
Sir, doubt, sir.
Right, tell me.
Sir, not doubt, sir. Did you write anything, sir? Now only I joined, sir. Anything before?
Now only I started.
Okay, sir.
This eukaryotic, prokaryotic ribosome we are discussing. This has two subunits. A larger subunit, which is 50S subunit, and a smaller subunit, which is 30S subunit. 50 plus 30, 80, na sir? How 70S, sir? Here, what is S? S is sedimentation rate. Sedimentation rate. That sedimentation rate is measured in Swedberg unit. What is the sedimentation rate? Here normally that cell organelles, we can separate them by using a process called centrifugation. There is a method called as centrifugation for the separation of the organelles based on their density. So when we are separating, they are sedimenting. Sedimenting means small, larger molecules will sediment bottom. Suppose we take a water which is mixed with a soil particle. If we add soil particles to water and if we mix thoroughly, shake vigorously, and if you keep it for some time, larger particles will settle down first, then smaller molecules, then even smaller molecules. Like that, based on the sizes, they will sediment. Sedimentation means settling down. So that sedimentation rate is a property of this subunit. Based on that sedimentation rate, they are divided into this one. So larger subunit has 50 Swedberg units, so it is called as a 50S subunit. Smaller subunit has 30 units of sedimentation rate or Swedberg unit, so it is called as 30S subunit based on their sedimentation rate. But when both are combined, that complete ribosome, 70S ribosome, it has 70 Swedberg units only. That's why it is called as 70S ribosome. If we add this to 50, 30, 80 will come. Okay. But this is entire subunit, entire ribosome will have only 70 Swedberg units of sedimentation rate. Okay. This is like, where is Mysore and Mysore Bonda? Yes? There is no Mysore and Mysore Bonda. Similarly, there is no 80 in that. Okay. Right. This is, I gave you molecular weight of this one. 70S ribosome, it has 2.7 into 10 power 6 Daltons of molecular weight is there. This we discussed in previous class, that molecular weight. Then see, 80S ribosome. Is called as eukaryotic ribosome. Where it is present? It is present on endoplasmic reticulum in eukaryote cell. All eukaryote cells have endoplasmic reticulum. On the surface of endoplasmic reticulum, especially the presence of these ribosomes on endoplasmic reticulum make that ribosomes rough. If ribosomes are present on this endoplasmic reticulum, then the ribosome will be rough endoplasmic reticulum. Our board is not clear. It is very clear. It is very clear. I am recording that also. If the same problem is there, you can leave the meeting and rejoin, no problem. So rough endoplasmic reticulum. These 80S ribosomes which are present on surface of endoplasmic reticulum make that ribosome as rough. So there is formation of this one. It has 4.6 into 10 power 6 Daltons of molecular weight. Molecular weight is 4.6 into 10 power 6 Daltons. And this 80S ribosome is also made up of two subunits. One larger subunit is there, that is 60S subunit, and a smaller subunit is there, which is 40S subunit. If we write the structure of this eukaryotic ribosome, eukaryotic ribosome is somewhat large in size than prokaryotic ribosome. 80S ribosome is large in size than prokaryotic ribosome. This is a 40S, 60S, totally 80S ribosome. 80S ribosome is present on endoplasmic reticulum of eukaryotic cell. 70S ribosome is present on cytoplasm of eukaryotic cells and organelles of eukaryotic, cytoplasm and organelles of eukaryotic cell, and prokaryotes also have that 70S ribosome in their cytoplasm. 80S ribosome is present on endoplasmic reticulum in eukaryotic cell. 70S ribosome, where it is present, means in prokaryotic cytoplasm, 70S ribosome is there, and in eukaryotic organelles like mitochondria and chloroplast, there is presence of 70S ribosome. So eukaryotic cells have both 70S and 80S ribosome, but the prokaryotic cells have only 70S ribosome. Okay, now see that the composition of that ribosome. Copy this. Dalton. Dalton is unit of molecular weight. Dalton. Dalton is originally, he is a scientist. He is a chemist. That Dalton is chemist. Okay, he found that giving molecular weight to chemical substances. So that Dalton is unit of molecular weight. Then see the chemical composition of ribosome. What are present in this ribosome? Ribosomes are originally nuclear proteins in nature. Ribosomes are nuclear proteins. What are that nuclear proteins means? Nucleic acid. Nucleic acid here is RNA and proteins are there. Nuclear proteins means nucleic acid and protein. They will combine and form nuclear protein. What is the nucleic acid found here is RNA. RNA is a nucleic acid. With that there is attachment of protein and form a kind of nuclear protein named ribosomes. Okay. They are nucleoproteins which are made up of RNA and protein. If you see 70S ribosome, what are chemical composition, chemical components which are present in 70S ribosome? 70S ribosome has what? 50S subunits, 50S, 30S subunits, and three types of RNA. Normally RNA, RNA stands for ribonucleic acid, you know. That RNA is again divided into messenger RNA, transfer RNA and ribosomal RNA. RRNA is a type of RNA which is present in ribosome. That's why it is called as ribosomal RNA or RRNA. Here, this is made up of three types of RRNA. What are the three types of RRNA? They are 23S RRNA, 23S RRNA, 5S RRNA, and 18S RRNA. Not 18, 16. 16S RRNA. Three times. Here S for Swedberg unit or sedimentation rate. Based on the size of RNA molecules, they have different sizes or sedimentation rate. RNA size is more means S value will be more. RNA size is less means RNA, this S value will be less. 5S RRNA means its size is less. 23S RRNA means its size is more. So based on the size of RNAs, we can give S value also. So this 70S ribosome is made up of a larger subunit and a smaller subunit. 50S subunit, 30S subunit. That 50S subunit and 30S subunit, they are made up of different types of RNA molecules and many proteins also. Around 20 plus 30 and around 50 proteins. Different proteins and three types of RNA molecules are combined to give 70S ribosome. Then 80S ribosome. 80S ribosome is made up of 60S subunits, 40S subunit with more than 80 proteins, around 80 different proteins, and there is presence of four types of RNA. Four types of ribosomal RNA. What are that four types of ribosomal RNAs? Are 28, 5.8, 16, 28S RRNA, 5S RRNA, 5.8S RRNA, and 18S RRNA. These are four different RNAs which are present in ATS ribosome. ATS ribosome has four different RNAs along with 80 proteins. So that 80 proteins with four types of RNAs combine together and form ATS ribosome. Sir, ATS ribosome present in which organelle? In previous classes we discussed chloroplast, mitochondria. Can you read three types of RNA? mRNA, tRNA, rRNA. That is three types of RNA. In that rRNA, RNA three types. mRNA, tRNA and rRNA. In that rRNA, based on the size, these are again different. How many proteins are present in 70th ribosome? See here, 50, around 50 proteins. Okay? Complete? Sir, is that 5. Yes, rRNA. Yes. Yes, rRNA. 5. rRNA. 5.8. Yes, rRNA. And 18. Yes, rRNA. Okay. Vaishika, don't forget. This week you promised you will get maximum marks. Very good marks. Then your friend. Who is your friend? Yeah, don't forget. Yes. If we see the structure of ribosome, there is presence of a small subunit, whatever it is, 70. Okay. Is it visible now? Yeah. So, some disturbance came. Anyway, there is presence of two subunits. A smaller subunit and a larger subunit. There is presence of many ribosomes, RNA. Many ribosomal RNA molecules are there. Many ribosomal RNA molecules like that. See, in smaller subunit there is presence of 70s. I mean, not, I didn't say particularly smaller and larger. See, 70s ribosome has three types of RNA. Three types, not number three. That is not number three. That is type three. Okay. There is presence of some this ribosomal RNA. The ribosomal RNAs may be connected, interconnected each other. This is one RNA like that. They are connected to each other. See here, in larger subunit also there is some ribosome, but due to this presence of protein, how many proteins are present in prokaryotic and eukaryotic ribosome? Prokaryotic ribosome has around 50 proteins and eukaryotic ribosome has around 80 proteins. Due to presence of that number of proteins in ribosomes, that ribosomes will form some binding sites. This protein will act as enzymes also. Okay, here there is presence of two sites. One is C. C. C site stands for peptidyl. A site stands for amino acyl. A site is also called as amino acyl site, which is also called as binding. Second one is called as condensing. So there is presence of peptidyl site and amino acyl site in this larger subunit, along with that many RNA molecules. Whatever the RNA molecules here, there may be presence of many RNA molecules also here. That many RNA molecules may be interconnected like this, or they may be free. So, whatever, what are these? These are RNA molecules, rRNA. Ribosomal RNA molecules are combined with proteins. This is the structure of ribosome. This, why I wrote this structure is, this structure ribosome is very important. It is responsible for the formation of protein. In function, I will tell you that. Okay. Then sometimes there is formation of group of ribosomes. Group of ribosomes. Many ribosomes will combine together. That is called polysome. When this polysome is formed means during protein synthesis. I told you ribosomes are responsible for protein synthesis. In function, I will explain again. Is the diagram complete? One second. Okay, you can write. Complete. smaller unit also have protein. Both are made up of proteins only. Yeah, Lohitni, don't forget. Your friend Vaisika is going to be big competition to you. W weight portion I told you already at beginning of the class. What I told you at beginning of the class, WPT portions I will give you based on the syllabus completion today. Up to the completion of syllabus today, then I will give you portion. What you wrote below the group of ribosome? What I wrote? Polysome. Polysomes. Okay, no problem. You joined lately, so you don't know about WPT. At the end of the class, I will give. Okay. Right. See where this ribosomes are formed. Formation of the ribosomes is called as biogenesis. Here, 70th ribosome formed in cytoplasm of prokaryotes and plastids mitochondria of eukaryotes. In plastids and mitochondria of eukaryotes and cytoplasm of prokaryotes, 70th ribosome will form. 70th ribosome is synthesizing there. Where it is synthesizing? Cytoplasm of prokaryotes and matrix of mitochondria and matrix of plastid. 80th ribosome, where 80th ribosome is forming? 80th ribosome, where it is present? On endoplasmic reticulum. So it forms in nucleolus of nucleus. Nucleus is present in what eukaryotic cells, you know. Okay, in that nucleus, there is presence of nucleolus. Inside that nucleolus, there is synthesis of ribosomes and the ribosomes are present on surface of endoplasmic reticulum. Sir, still didn't confirm a WPT or CPT. I think only 3 WPT is completed, no? If 4th WPT is complete, then 5th one will be CPT. Okay. We'll think if CPT is there, one day revision you may get based on the chance. And functions of this ribosome. Major function of this ribosome is synthesis of proteins. Ribosomes majorly function as protein synthesizing machineries. Protein synthesizing machineries. So these ribosomes are also called protein factories. Ribosomes are also called protein factories. Biogenesis is the formation of production of Golgi apparatus. Whatever the membrane bound organelles production, that is everything is called as biogenesis. Production of membrane bound organelles is biogenesis. Formation of vacuole is biogenesis. Formation of lysosome is biogenesis. formation of Golgi is also biogenesis. So ribosomes are involved in here. Okay, then we go for, this is ribosome complete, then we go for another structure, another organelle. Meeting is going to end up. Yeah, 3 minutes are there. We can use that 3 minutes also. Next structure, next organelle, microbodies, name itself, small structures which are present in cell, they are called as microbodies. These are single membraned spherical bodies, single membrane bound spherical bodies. They are spherical in shape and they are single membrane bound organelles, and they have a diameter of 0.2 to 1.5 micron. Diameter is 0.2 to 1.5 micron. Mu means micron. The diameter of microbodies is 0.2 to 1.5 micron. Here they have a central, these are single membrane bound spherical bodies. No, these are single membrane bound spherical bodies. At center there is presence of a granular structure. That granular structure has some enzymes. Okay, see here, they have a diameter of 0.2 to 1.5 microns and they have a central granular body. Yes, central granular body that has some enzymes that, as a granular in structure, it forms a crystal structure, crystalloid core we can say, contains some enzymes which are responsible for some metabolic processes. So these are single membrane bound spherical structures, right? In that spherical structure at central there is presence of a granular body. That granular body we can say crystalloid core. Granular body is called crystalloid core. That crystalloid core contains enzymes. These enzymes are responsible for particular metabolic processes. Enzymes carry metabolic reaction. Particularly one enzyme is there means that will carry out one particular reaction. So these are again divided into majorly